They say this is a big rich town. I just come from the poorest part. Bright light, city life, I gotta make it. This is where it goes down. I just happen to come up hard.
I don't hear nothing. All right, here we go. Here I go, man.
There we go, Shad.
I never took a straight path nowhere. Life's full of twists and turns, bumps and bruises. I live, I learn. I'm from the city of the
devil. Ooh, good fade out, Shad. Good fade out. Fade that joint out. Fade that joint out. We here.
Another motherfucking week.
Another motherfucking week, niggas.
Boosie would be Ghost. I would definitely be.
I'm definitely Ghost.
Talk about what power characters movie would be.
If I was a power character, I'm definitely Ghost.
I think I'm Kanan. I think I would be Kanan.
I mean, Tommy for Tommy? No, I ain't Tommy. I'm probably Tyreek.
No, you're definitely Tommy. You're Tommy for Tommy. Me and you are definitely
Tom for
beefing.
Tom?
Me and you are definitely beefing for the top, and we off Gunna already. So.
Pause. Y'all didn't off me.
Pause.
Off, you know what I'm saying? The cops off me.
Pause, yeah.
That was definitely pause.
Well, we definitely set you up, though.
Yeah. Y'all do be setting me up. That's crazy.
He definitely set you up though.
Gunna is fucking Governor Tate.
Smoking Reggie. Nigga, get the fuck out of here, man. Nigga, yo, this Tate. The Lit Kings, man. We don't smoke Reggie.
Yo, episode 105 Literally Speaking Podcast.
105, man. We running through this shit.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
You got Boosie 215, the favorite host with the most.
Gunna Fly, Mr. Two Wise, Mr. Witcher McCauley, Macaulay Culkin.
And I'm Tom Flies. How y'all doing?
Hey, yo, if I sound a little crazy this week because I'm under the weather, man.
You sound exactly the same like you do every week. But we here.
Hey, look at that.
Anybody be seeing how Tate be making them nut ass fucking Disney villain faces and shit?
Dog, I don't know what's up with Tate.
He be killing me.
Tate been drawing.
Bro, he like, be making them.
John 215, what up? Ice Studios.
John 215, what up? Drunk Cakes, you already know what it is. If you want to feel like us while you listening to us,
yo, stop promoting
fuck
that.
Fuck with them Drunk
yo,
Cakes.
Yo, starting next week, we no longer promote Drunk Cakes until we
yo, Drunk Cakes, here. Man. The slogan is in the name.
Yeah, man, this nigga telling me, man. Hey, yo, shout out to Drunk Cakes.
Make sure
y'all
follow the Drunk Cakes.
Hey, yo, Baltimore,
page.
You already know what it
put
is.
Put in
man.
Your pre-orders right now. You know what I'm saying? Even if you can't directly order through the Lit Kings, you can definitely always pre-order through Drunk Cakes. Send them the promo code, hashtag we got it lit, and you will get a $5. No, I'm lying. But you will just get some credit.
I can't wait till my sponsorship fall through.
Hey, yo, let's get this shit out the way right now, man. November 10th, this fucking week. Why are you listening to
this? Sunday.
Sunday, this fucking Sunday. Come out, man. The Lit Kings hosting a great fucking show, man. We at Voltage Lounge, man. I don't know the fucking address of Vultures Lounge.
742 North 7th Street. I don't know if that's right, yet, but it sounds good.
But if you're from Philly, you know where the fuck Vultures Lounge at,
it's in between 7th and 8th and Spring Garden, right next to the Electric Factory. You know what I mean?
Shout out to Wild Boy Gang, NABH, DJ Dior going to be on the boards, man. Come out, man.
Definitely going to have some special guests, some special guest performances in the house. You know what I'm saying? So definitely come through. And you already know, your boys is hosting it. You already know. You got the host with the most in the crib. And you got Tom Flies going to be in the building. And you got Kanan. So, you know what I mean? It's going to be a show.
It's definitely going to be a show. But let's get to it, man.
Yeah, I'll be for the applause. But I guess we ain't getting this week. You know what I'm saying? It's all
shout on this shit this week.
There we go.
We're here. Shout out to everybody listening on Spotify, SoundCloud.
Shout out to KBZ with the fly, Michael Kors, Rain Breaker 1. Check out.
We appreciate every single last one of y'all.
Please hit that subscribe button on YouTube, everybody.
Keep hitting it.
Keep hitting that subscribe button on YouTube. Hit that subscribe button on iTunes, Spotify. Whatever the fuck you listening to us on, please hit that subscribe button, y'all.
Shout out to my guy, last week's guest, Armani White.
Yo, ho, what we hearing?
That's me.
Come on,
man. All right, great fucking guest, too.
Oh, I can't do it right here.
All
right. We having a little technical difficulties.
Time flies.
My bad. But so shout out to Armani White for coming through last week, man. Make sure y'all go get his project.
Yo, man.
And yes, yo, Tom, talk. Speak up more about that.
I can't. What you mean speak up more? I can't hear him.
Let him know the project name and shit, because that joint definitely coming out, man.
Yeah, man. Armani White's first project, Keep in Touch, dropping this Friday, man. Tomorrow. So when y'all hear it, tonight at midnight. So when y'all,
He just dropped the artwork for
it. Just go get it, man. Shout out to Armani, man. That's my guy.
What that joint called again?
Keep in Touch.
Keep in touch, man. Definitely keep in touch on that joint, yo.
Yeah, man. So, yeah. And definitely got to give boys props one more time, though, for definitely being one of our top guests. I can't.
Like, Bull... Boy was a good guest, bro. Like, the type of quality conversation that we had with him, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, like, he definitely enlightened
for somebody that we didn't prep before, like the show and everything, and just to come right on and just felt like it was a fourth co-host for that day. You know what I'm saying? And that's generally for just like putting it out there for all our guests to come on. You know what I'm saying? That's generally how the show is supposed to go. You know what I mean? It's like your fourth guest, your fourth host for the day. You know what I'm saying? Regular conversation. The people want to feel you as a regular person before we just dive. They already know what you do before we dive into your personal, I guess not your personal life, but your entertainment world. Digging, we want to see how you react to regular shit, how you think as a person, like what would you do if you was in that type of situation and type shit like that. You know what I mean? Just feeling you out as a regular. You know what I mean? Giving your fans that regular perspective of you as a regular person.
Yeah, man. He definitely was a good boy.
Once again, an extended soliloquy from Mr. Gunna Fly.
Yeah, I just,
but y'all understand what he's saying.
I can't say that soliloquy word no more, man. I got condemned for that. They said that's my favorite word.
Fuck yeah, soliloquy? Nigga. Once you learn a new word, nigga, you be running that shit in a hole.
I could definitely see soliloquy being your favorite word.
It's one of them.
But let's get to the fucking shits, man.
Yo, we here.
Flabbergasted.
Yo, if y'all... Wait, just in case y'all haven't heard, y'all don't hear a fourth voice. No, that's because we're here on our lonely this week. No more guests, as of for right now. So,
man, we was on a fucking roll as a guest. I ain't even gonna lie to you though. I didn't want to talk to no fucking body this week.
Oh, that's false.
Yo,
man, we ain't even 10 minutes in, and niggas is lying, yo. Niggas is lying. Come on, we ain't even man. 10 minutes
like, you supposed to be with me, dog. Like.
Niggas
supposed to be with me, man.
I listen, we rocking, bro.
But on some real shit though, I didn't want to talk to nobody because it's like we haven't been just us for a while in the studio. You know what I mean? Like every week we had somebody here, we got to talk to somebody, we got to interview, and I don't feel like interviewing people every week. Like sometimes I just want to talk shit, come in here, bust it up with my niggas. That's it.
It's a fact.
Big fact.
So we here. So how everybody doing, man? How everybody feeling?
Everybody's good, man.
I'm under the weather, but I'm good.
I know Gunna was out with his gold vote pins and knocking door.
Strong campaign week. Yeah, man, I'm definitely.
Man, Gunna, you ain't use your fucking platform right, nigga. Last week you supposed to be on this bitch telling everybody to vote. Like,
nigga,
like,
I did not.
You ain't really go in, man. You ain't really go in. You ain't
I told niggas to go
right,
vote.
Man. You ain't use your platform.
I
right,
told
man.
Niggas to go vote. Yeah, you know I mean,
you listen, ain't real.
I am the realest of the motherfucking realest. Like I said, we had a strong campaign week. 3 out of the 4 candidates we endorsed actually won. So it still was a strong campaign. Huh? Yeah, of course. Shout out to the Working Families Party. Shout out to Miss Councilperson Kendra Brooks officially. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to Kendra Brooks. Hey, yo, shout out to
the community. I like to call her the community auntie. You know what I'm saying? She's definitely a homebred mother from North Philly that's taking on the mantle of being a council person. So it's definitely a task that she has in front of her, but I think she has the right mind for the community. You know what I'm saying? And then you got Isaiah Thomas, not the basketball player, but Isaiah Thomas and also Helen Gim. So, you know what I mean? The community is looking, we definitely going to look to get some things addressed after these first 100 days. So, you know what I mean? It's definitely some good things coming
yeah,
up.
Yeah, and don't skip past anything he just said, you little dumb niggas. Y'all need to listen to this shit we talking. Yeah. Nigga, this is the part where niggas skip past the 15-second button like, all right, I'm skipping this. No.
Right.
No.
Right. Finally, nigga, you using your platform right, man.
Pay attention.
You know what I'm saying? Finally.
Yeah, can y'all hear me?
We can hear you.
All right,
yeah, we can hear you.
So, yeah, so we know how Gunna doing. Boosie, everything good?
I'm good, bro. I'm good, man. I'm good, man. I don't really want to talk about personal life. You know, shit is changing out here, man.
It's a lot going on, man.
It's a lot going on, man. But I'll be back.
It's about to get back.
If y'all was
it's all about
man,
the get back. You heard? Started, it's all about the get back.
We started the episode with the Power theme song for a reason, man. Because today and today only we came to the studio for one thing this week. And that's real to shit. Figure out who shot Ghost.
Nigga, we know.
Hashtag who shot Ghost.
Nigga, go back to what? When did Power start?
Let's
what
talk
episode
about the
was
whole
we
episode.
On?
Let's we gotta talk about the whole episode.
I mean, obviously, but I'm just
yeah. We definitely gotta talk about the whole episode because Ghost was on the road through the whole fucking episode. Dog.
Yo, this
nigga since
was
like
killing me, bro.
First of all, I ain't gonna lie.
I wanted
like
to
I
shoot
said,
Ghost.
Yo, before on some real shit though, I ain't gonna lie. Twitter fucking ruined this shit for me,
always.
Dog.
Shout out Twitter.
I tell you how.
Shout
I tell you
I
how.
I didn't go on no social
you
media
know,
the whole day.
But no, I forgot about it. I forgot right. It was Saturday morning. Like I tell Tom, I just get up just to do a daily. you know, just to see what's going on, check the landscape and shit. And what I see, soon I get on it, I'm like, hell no. Like, come on, dog. And it forced me to watch it that morning.
Just, I watched it that night.
Dog.
At 12 a.m. Saturday.
I don't even think I watched the motherfucker until, like, damn near, like, Monday.
For real? So you ain't hear about nothing?
No, I didn't. I stayed away from motherfuckers.
Well, we know you ain't on social media.
I am on social media.
No, you're not.
Nigga, I am on social media. I clearly didn't go on my social media purposely for that.
He on Black Planet.
Niggas don't even remember Black Planet.
Right, but that's the shit that you want.
Yeah, that was like MySpace before it was MySpace. But I literally try not to go like scroll down my timeline on like Saturday and Sunday.
Yo, let me get a light.
Especially while power is in motherfucking motion, because like, listen, nigga, man, they ruined Keisha for me. That's why
niggas needed that.
That's why I stopped going on, because I was like, damn, I know I'm not supposed to go on social media on the weekend because I know I'm about to ruin fucking power.
Well, man, the episode all in all to me was a good episode. Like, not like a great episode. It was cool, you know what I mean? Like, I didn't really like the fucking ending of how he was falling. Like, that shit was fucking bananas.
Nigga died like fucking Mufasa.
Yeah, like, I ain't know what was going on. I'm like, why is he... First of all, the green screen behind him was nasty. Like, the whole scene was nasty. Yeah, yeah, like
the
shot...
The CGI was
like,
so horrible.
The CGI was so horrible on that shit. I was like, oh my God, why is this shit so nasty like this? Like, the blood and everything. I'm like, this shit is horrible. But like, they could have did way better on this. Way better for the...
Tom.
For that.
You said something very, even though it was a little bit of a joke, you said something real significant there in the imagery. That's how motherfuckers like motherfuckers that do film, that's how they be trying to do shit and tie shit. And that fall was very reminiscent of
Mufasa.
Yeah, Mufasa. So that's letting you know.
He said the fall was like Mufasa.
That's a dead ass giveaway of, like, you know what I'm saying? Who the fuck, you know what I mean, shot or supposedly killed, possibly Ghost.
Mufasa? Scar?
No. Nigga, fucking Tariq.
Scar. Scar killed Ghost.
Yeah, Scar.
I mean, Scar killed Mufasa. What am I talking about?
Yeah, what the fuck is you talking about? I'm like, Scar, what?
Scar killed Mufasa.
I thought this nigga was over here trying to joke.
You're not going to tie in Scar to Tariq.
I'm talking about the imagery, like, you know what I mean, showing the father falling, like the mm-hmm. father's dying, and now the son has to really assume the position.
I get
king,
it.
But instead... But no. Really, like, Mufasa and Scar is brothers. So the only person that could probably kill
is Tommy.
The nigga, the king, is really the motherfucker Tommy. That could get close to him.
Yo, you getting too deep. How you tying power to Lion King, dog? You the first nigga to even do this. Like, I've been listening to a lot of podcasts, and you the first boy to tie in fucking Lion King to power.
Can we really get into this mid-season finale, though?
Yes, let's get into it.
All the significant parts and all the parts that really just was like, what, yo? All right. What was the most significant part to y'all in the finale to y'all?
What you mean? Like,
well, first of all, I want to say this. I'm going to start by saying this.
Well,
Ghost was in his bag for no reason
right,
at all.
That's what I'm saying. That was the significant part through the whole episode, was him just drawing,
and I'm gonna tell
like,
y'all my theory.
Telling everybody, you ain't stopping me. I'm like, why the fuck is he going so hard like this? Like, you ain't stopping me. You ain't stopping
literally
me.
Everybody.
You ain't stopping me. I don't give a fuck. I'm out of this joint. I'm cold turkey. Nobody's fucking stopping me, Duke.
It was the reverse of last week's episode, where it seemed like everything, like the walls were closing in, and it seemed like, oh, Ghost might actually finally get caught this time. With the Terry Silver situation and all that shit like that, with the body in the trunk, them finding the phone.
The judge threw that shit right the fuck out.
Right the fuck out.
Leave this man alone.
So literally, it became again like shit.
Even then,
nothing can stop this nigga.
That part was like fake. I thought she was lying to him to get them to like snitch or something.
Who?
When she went up to like the judge, it's not. We tried to pursue it and it's not going to work.
Right. No, I ain't gonna lie. I thought that was some Fugazi shit too, dude. I thought that was like, you know, like
her like trying to finesse.
Yeah, trying to finesse shit. I thought that was a deploy as well. But when she was going to everybody though, you know what I mean? I'm like, yeah, this shit is a rap. It's a rap.
Yo, every time I see Dre, I think about. I'm just gonna talk about it. Ghost was drawing the whole episode. He was snapping. Here's the shit I had a problem with, right? was, for one, he was the running mate, the girl running for governor, and how he was she was talking all this, Dan St. Patrick, glad to have you, yada yada yada. And then like, why is the QCP? It's to secure the black vote. Soon as they said like, yo, the QCP got shut down, she like,
she straight,
oh well, fuck you.
Yeah, you,
we gonna go get Tate.
Right.
Like, so I was like, well damn, that was quick.
But it was all about the black vote.
I get it.
It was all about the black
vote. But that was like a quick turn of events. Like, and then he had to scramble, end up finding his uncle we never seen.
Never, now that
never
was.
Never ever heard about.
I was fucking confused like shit about that.
And got him to sell his bar just like that.
Yes, I was confused like shit about that. Like, who the fuck is this bull?
You know that was only content
Who
purposes.
Is this guy?
That was for storyline.
And then the story he came up with and all that shit.
Know,
I was like,
I told your dad, stay away from those guys on the streets, man. Bro, it's just how convenient was that, bro? Like, come on, that's like,
it just seemed
corny.
Like he came from a long line of ratting.
That was corny as shit.
And Ghost, just he's a little bit notorious for his ratting abilities. Like, he's like a low key rat,
then,
though. Like,
who the hell came in? How Jason died, right? And obviously the Jason was his big kingpin or whatever, and they know the last person he was with was Ghost, and he's still walking the streets untouched. Like, nigga, he's in Truth every day, door unlocked,
right? Don't nobody
posted up drinking.
Like, nobody is going back to that part. Like, the biggest kingpin that been running everything, he gets off. And none of his
he's
goons,
always with like 50 people.
Yes, none of his goons is running the street trying to figure out who did this shit,
even though they know where club he be at. And it's all, he's always there by himself. Nobody's ever at the club with him. No security, no nothing. He always take a couple shots. And yet nobody's ran up on Ghost to touch him.
First of all, why is Truth open all of a sudden?
I don't think it's back open. Then somebody just got killed in Truth. Tate just shot somebody.
Yep.
And bro, it's a lot.
But that was more like a heroic moment. So it's like.
Still.
Man, yo, Power, go finish, go ahead. Go ahead.
What else happened in there that, of course, and then it ended. Everybody just decides, you know, we're going to walk up to the club together. And in broad daylight.
It wasn't broad daylight.
What? Yo, I could have sworn. Only person at the scene looked dark was Angela's sister.
No, all they seen was dark.
I'll be back about it again.
All they seen was dark. Everybody seen was dark.
Still. They all walking. Lowing their guns in the street.
Right. Like, niggas New York in the car, lowing the guns. Everybody lowing guns on the way to Truth, man. Like, I ain't get that shit either. Like, they was a fucking army or some
they
shit.
Get
like,
to the front like, door, like,
a, right? Yeah, like, everybody, like, oh, we all together to go get this nigga?
Let's go
get this boy, man. Hey, yo, like, the whole shit was fucking confusing, dog. Like, I just didn't understand it. And just like with Angela's sister, just like, one scene before that, she was saying,
no, I
how
know you ain't killed my
I know
sister.
You ain't killed my
I
sister.
You.
I forgive you and shit.
Then it was like, but fuck you, fuck, nigga. Can fuck I get this nigga in jail?
Yeah, like, what's going on here? Like,
and they like, nah.
Power, man, is just everywhere this season, man. Like, this shit is doing a lot of twisting and turning.
I told you, man. They said it's like Tony Ayo write the fucking scripts, man.
But I was kind of at that crossroads, too, because I'm like, damn, what is it with good-ass TV shows? And when you get to the motherfucking end, it seems like they always start fucking up.
They don't know
like,
how to close it.
Yo, they don't know how to
close. They don't know how to close shit, dog. They don't know how to close it,
who's
man.
The one, John, the white one?
Sopranos,
that shit ended corny.
Everything ends corny, dog. Everything ends corny, man. Nothing really ends good.
Didn't your show end corny, too?
What?
Game of Thrones?
Yeah, they said that last season was the worst season.
I ain't gonna say it. It could have been better. It could have been. It could have been better, but that's it wasn't bad.
And, you said your man died too easy.
Shout out to my nigga, man.
And then that's what I'm saying. Now, Power, we at this crossroads where it's like, I ain't gonna hold you. I really feel like Ghost is not gonna be dead. Like,
but
I really feel like
no Ghost is not dead. That's why they keep saying who shot him. You mean that's why they keep saying who shot him? He's not dead. He's definitely not dead.
But it's like, dog, Dre, like, just gets booked for a murder, bro, and he gets out
because
I'm gonna snitch.
Yes, and then she say, oh yeah, he was like, yeah, man, I saw him do it in the room or whatever. She's
like, no, in the garage.
You mean in the garage? She said, Oh yeah, the garage. Yeah, I was right there. And I told this. I told him don't do it.
And she doing that sack shit, and she getting all court the fuck up.
Right.
And it's like you go right back to do the shit again. And it's like you let this nigga out.
I hate sack so bad, bro.
Dog, I don't understand power, man. I don't know.
It's a lot of shit.
I think they really setting it up. They really set it up. Because they was like, fuck it, we're not gonna catch this nigga, we just gonna let these motherfuckers do whatever. We gonna let these motherfuckers get street justice. He got enough niggas that hate him, and that's why it's like
get street justice.
Right. But if you notice, that's what she was doing. She made it her duty to go back and really tell everybody that she tried to get to build up a case against him. She told him that, hey, look, fuck it, we can't do shit about it or whatever like that. That's typical cop shit. To get motherfuckers to do what the fuck they expect them to do, and it's to go get street justice. It's like, fuck it. You know what I'm saying? Make enough niggas out here mad, turn on this nigga to kill him.
Bro.
So who did it? Who shot him?
Tariq, nigga.
One of the theories I had was that, I seen somebody say was that he didn't really get shot. That it was like a vision. Like a vision. They were saying, like, what if it ended like this? Like,
I'm not gonna lie, with all this goofy shit that's going on with him, I never heard that. That came out of nowhere just now.
It was a video.
That could be some goofy shit that's going on with this nigga. But no, because how the cop react outside the joint, cause she heard it. She like, boom, she heard it and was looking like.
But yeah, in his perspective, he's seeing all these ghosts, no pun intended. Kanan, Angela, every episode. He's just talking to everybody. And then it's like the way he was talking to people was like, and the way they reacted to him saying, I don't need you. I'm going, nobody's going to stop me. The way they all react, Tommy was like fine with it, like, and then dipped off. Tasha was fine with it, dipped off. Tariq was like, what? And then he walked, everybody just was cool with it. That way he was talking to him. Like, that's why I was like, this don't look believable. Like,
No. What you trying to say? That shit was some dream shit?
Yeah, it was a dream.
No, fuck no. It was not no dream.
And you go
it
back.
It was not no dream, bro.
And you wake up.
It was not a dream.
And somebody said that the whole thing was a dream and that when if he did get shot, it's going to wake him up. He can go back. He was like daydreaming in the club, like the first episode when he first seen Angela and seeing how his life with his pimp turned out. And he's not going to go and pursue her.
Man, get the fuck out of here, man. Fuck no. I ain't here for that dumb, goofy ass shit.
And it's going to all start over?
Yep. Yeah, fuck go no. Off. No, stop. No.
So the whole
no.
Show never happened.
No.
The whole
no.
Show
if that
never
shit
happened.
Was to happen, that would be by far the corniest shit ever.
The whole show
yes,
never
that
happened.
That shit would be the corniest shit ever, dog. No.
So that means you go
no.
Back to fucking.
No.
He's still dealing with Lobos. Uh-huh. All this shit, like
yeah, all that shit was a dream.
Yep.
All these no. Agents are not dead now.
I can
all
see
of a sudden,
though.
You can see that.
I can see them pulling some shit like that.
Tom, stop, bro, stop.
I can see them
stop
shit
it.
Like that.
And like Gunna said, that'd be the corniest shit ever, dog.
Some Empire
that should be the corniest shit ever. I don't even know what's going on Empire, man.
I don't even know what's
like,
going on.
Nobody
Empire.
Do.
Like what's fucking going on Empire?
Last thing I heard was fucking Lucius had a motherfucking witness protection dreads and shit. Like,
oh, that was last season.
That was last
yeah,
season.
Ain't nobody watching.
It's
Empire.
A new season.
Yeah, this season, the final season.
Ain't nobody watching Empire.
Oh, this the final season of Empire too?
Yeah.
They gay as shit.
Yo. Yo,
forgive me for the lingo. 50. Shout out to the LGBTQ.
If the season finale don't end with many men, man, you ain't do us.
Yo,
no
I know who shot him.
Tariq.
Nah, it wasn't Tariq, man.
Ramona.
No,
I hate
yo,
the way
I'm
she
smiled. It was the it got to be out of two people. The babysitter boy.
The babysitter.
Q? I don't know this nigga name.
Q.
What? That's his name. Q. He got a name. He got a letter.
Who the fuck is babysitter?
Then he'd be like, yo, I love you, Tasha.
Yeah, that nigga.
With you, even though I don't know you.
That nigga.
But I love
or,
you. Fuck your baby
or
dad.
You got to remember, he made a call to the ball in jail. He probably had him shoot, had somebody pay to shoot him.
From jail. Couldn't do that in the street.
Yo, Doug, I'm trying to tell you. It's power.
Nah.
What did he need him to do? We don't know what Ghost asked him to do. He was like, he said, yo, I need you to do a joint.
After
for
he
me.
Just about to kidnap his son and had them going on, you man, niggas just be too cool. Niggas be trying to kill each other one day, next day, be like, yo, let's work together.
We got to remember what happened in the show, man. We got to remember what happened in the show, man. And that's two crucial things that happened that nobody's talking about, dog. It could be the babysitter boy or it was him.
Vincent.
Or Vincent, whoever the fuck he is. Yeah, Vincent. I don't remember niggas' names.
Nah, it wouldn't have been Vincent. I don't think it's Vincent. You didn't.
The nigga said, how the hell Two Bit and Spanky?
Because it's somebody that they didn't show. It's not going to be somebody that they show. You know what I mean? It's, they going to go somebody that they didn't show that was behind the scenes. You know what I mean?
But my thing is,
I got to do it for my daughter. I got to get out of jail for my daughter.
Yo, Drake daughter popping.
I got to go to the store for my daughter.
The baby. The baby.
I got to drink water for my daughter.
Dog.
Everything be for this nigga daughter, yo.
Dog. Where was his daughter at when he was in jail? Where did his daughter
go? Man, you're not going to tell this nigga to give two fucks about his daughter, dog. Out of nowhere. Yeah. Like,
one, hold on. How the fuck is Dre daughter still the same age and baby girl like 8?
Well, Dre daughter only been there for a season.
No. She was there like fucking season 3, my nigga.
Yo, where's Ghost third child?
You never see her.
Baby girl, right? Baby girl, you see her like every leap year episode.
Yeah, where she at?
She was 8. She with the grandma.
Now she like 13.
Oh, she with the grandma? That's the story.
I'd be wanting to punch the grandma too. But
I don't get it. How the
you
fuck?
I be selling drugs, Tasha.
How the fuck Tasha got a daycare and you still don't see baby girl?
Yo, man, we don't know. We would never know.
Then they set the whole storyline up with Tariq at school for this shit to go in the drain. Yep. So I don't know, man. We'll see, man. January 5th, we'll find out who shot Ghost.
If I'm right.
Like, the babysitter John might just be there, but no, Tasha was already on her way.
It's some goofy
so
shit.
So it wouldn't, like.
But he said in the joint, he was like, yo, you want me to handle it? Like, he pressing too much to try and handle
he
the situation.
He don't even know
situation.
Who that nigga is.
He do know who Ghost is. He know who Ghost is. And he be trying to act like he's somebody. Don't nobody know what the fuck he doing. You get what I'm saying? So he probably came through, shot it.
Yeah, that would be corny, though. But, yeah, I can see that. But that would be a fucking twist from just because it wouldn't be none of the characters that were seen. But
right. You get what I'm saying?
That concept would still be corny, though.
But who else could they? Yeah, I mean, it got to be somebody. It can't be, like, a random-ass person that we absolutely don't know.
Don't know, right.
Like, it got to be somebody that was seen before.
But it's like, this nigga ain't put no tick in. It's like, nigga, fuck you. Like, who the fuck is you? Like,
right.
Where did you get the gun
from? That's how we're going to figure out who the fuck this nigga
is. That's what I'm saying. But that shit would be so fucking corny. Like,
I'm with you. Like, this shit been corny regardless.
It was Trey Songz.
He fuck around. He fuck around be a fucking undercover agent. No, the whole fucking time.
Trey Songz shot Ghost. If Trey Songz shot Ghost, bro, send me to jail.
He said okay. Trey did it.
Real rap, dog.
I can see the babysitter. Over a theme song. I can see the babysitter being like an FBI motherfucking high ass, like super undercover ass nigga that finally got caught wind of them niggas. You know what I'm saying? And you know what I mean, tried to work his way in through Tasha.
No, we'll find out January 5th.
We'll definitely find out.
January 5th.
I'm mad that I gotta wait that long to find out that Tariq.
It's really like a month, bro. Like, it's already like November 6th, 7th.
But you have to wait a month to see that Tariq did it.
But this happens in mid-season finales all the time. Like,
Tariq.
You gotta wait.
Tariq, whatever the fuck.
You gotta wait.
We'll see. It was raining. But, yeah, man. Let's talk about the
And I think that's how Almighty. My man, before we get off of it, I think that's how they trying to if you paid attention to the episode when he was talking to his son, I think they trying to pave, you know, groundwork for
the spinoff show.
Yeah, for the spinoff show, because they was talking about his early shit too much, you know what I mean? And he got off of it. He was like, yo, this is what I was doing when I was a young boy, blah blah blah, you don't need to do that. So I think they probably going to try and do that, you know, show like the early girls.
No, the feds getting ready to close in on this nigga.
Man, they do that every episode, and then they be like, damn, can't get him.
Oh, no, we talked about that shit, Gunna, already. That shit done.
Ain't doing that.
The feds can't do nothing to him.
Let's talk about the Almighty Chicken Sandwich, man. Let's talk about it.
Let's talk about it.
It's back.
It's back.
Like Jordan.
The fucking Popeyes. The 4-5.
That shit definitely back like Jordan. I ain't gonna hold you.
Yo, definitely back like Jordan, dog. Because I thought when it was gonna come back, it wasn't gonna hit like that again.
No.
Dog, this shit is hitting again.
That shit is hitting again.
It's like Jordan wearing the 4-5. I ain't to play games with you.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, the shit is ridiculous. Like,
yo.
I went to try
first
and get
of all,
it. I tried
like
to get
the motherfucker
it. I ain't gonna lie.
Bigger.
I tried to get it. I ain't gonna lie. I tried to get the fucking sandwich like 2 or 3 times.
I got it.
I ain't
twice.
Get it. Oh, you. Damn.
Yo.
Oh, you must have been already outside.
Damn, yo,
on some
you ain't even bring them through the pot.
PSA.
That's crazy.
Listen, right, when the first go around happened with the chicken sandwiches, I wasn't, you know, buying into it. I wasn't buying into the hype.
I got it when it first came around.
Nah, I ain't really doing that. You know what I'm saying? This go around, I'm just like, you know what, dog? I'm right here. It's a Popeyes. It's, look, it's no line. Nobody was in there.
Right.
But me. So I'm like, though, it's somebody telling, giving me a message. Let me just buy the chicken sandwich, man. So I get it.
What store you was
got
at?
Got me a lemonade. Popeyes.
Which one?
What store was you at, nigga? I was at fucking Roscoe's.
Which one? So I can go to that
South
one.
South Philly.
Obviously, that's the one with the no line. Yeah. South Philly. Line, no way.
You know what I'm saying?
Niggas don't know it's back in South Philly yet.
Right.
I got the chicken sandwich and dog. That shit lived up to the fucking hype, yo. I swear to God. Go buy the chicken sandwich, yo. Cut in line if you got to.
No, don't cut in line.
You see?
No.
You see the shit he's sponsoring?
Do not cut in fucking line. No, no. Niggas is dying, bro. Niggas, yo, you're dying if you cut in line.
Rest in peace to the guy that died
over a fucking chicken sandwich?
We don't. You sound like John Wall right now. We don't want that happening.
Bro.
We definitely
you
don't
didn't
want
hear about that, bro.
Fuck no.
He got stabbed.
Bro, boy got stabbed up for trying to cut the line, bro. Boy ran down on him, said, nah, you ain't getting that. He got out of line to stab the boy up to get back in line.
And he still got served?
Yeah, and left.
While boy bleeding out, like, yo, man, hurry up, make my chicken sandwich.
Yo, bro, the shit is crazy out here,
hey,
man.
Y'all tweaking. It ain't that deep now. We never want that to go that far.
Like,
so no.
Employees is out here fighting each other. You ain't hear about that?
Fuck
that. Yes, bro. Yes. It's going down.
Yo, they taking that shit off the truck.
So,
take that shit home.
It was crazy.
Point,
It was down like in like Florida somewhere.
They said
like,
ain't never been this many Popeye employees on time a day in their life.
Dog, they said it was down like in Florida. So, I don't know if it was in Florida, but it was some fucking where. They said it was jamming so much. Like employees was like started going up because they was mad that there was so many customers. So many chicken sandwiches, shit was just getting crazy out there. The managers was throwing chickens at motherfuckers. Shit was just getting fucking crazy, bro. Like,
dog.
Yo,
I would have just put a whole motherfucking.
Yo, this fucking chicken sandwich
they just
got people.
To the door at this point.
Yo,
like, I would just give motherfuckers the bun and throw a whole motherfucking breast
niggas,
on that motherfucking.
They running out of buns. Yo, they running out of buns. They running out of chickens. They just running out of everything, man.
They gonna be out there reselling the resale.
And I don't know how Popeyes wasn't ready. They said they was ready for this. They were like, yo, we loaded up. How long it took them to come? Like 3 months to come back. 2 months.
Dog, you know how many chickens they had to kill and slaughter?
Dog, man, they said they was ready, man. Obviously, they wasn't ready, man.
They wasn't ready. Listen, man, that shit, y'all ever seen that
I'm glad
movie?
It's not going down like that in Philly, though. I'm glad.
It's
I ain't,
not, it was,
I'm
like
glad.
I said, no line, no wait.
It's lines, though. It's not definitely lines. Like, it's definitely time? Lines.
Y'all seen
it's
that
definitely
T-
lines.
Y'all seen that T.I. Joe on the track?
No.
Yeah, I seen it.
It's reminiscent of that shit.
When yeah, I seen it when they started sprinkling the shit in it. Yeah.
I think it's something in the sandwich, man.
Dog, the sandwich is good, man. I had it when it first came around. I ain't get it the second time. I'm trying to get the
like,
second
two
go around.
Is it
he said I had
bro,
two
that
of them.
Shit. Then, so, you know how I know it was good? Because I get it, right? So then I called Matt.
I ain't get the spicy. I got the regular.
I called Matt. I'm on the phone with Matt. And we talking about the gym or whatever. Now, I know but I'm like, yo, bro, you had a chance to get the chicken sandwich yet, yo? And he like, when a nigga go like this, that's how you know he was like, yo, that shit really that good? I'm like, yo real
man,
shit?
Yo, dog.
Then that's why I'm like, yo, all right.
Look
all
at Gunna. Gunna over that bitch like, dog.
He said, yo, I
didn't
believe
that. Gunna over that bitch look at his fucking chops, dog. Like, yo, I need that
he
in
was
my
like,
life,
I didn't believe
yo.
It, but yo, I believe
he,
it now.
He look just bro, like the bull on his shirt
take
right
it from
now.
Me,
like, yo
bro,
real
take
shit.
It from me, bro.
Listen,
that shit
yo,
there.
Gunna look
so
just like the
I just
ball
need
in his
to know,
fucking shirt.
I just need to know what the fuck is on it, like.
Nothing like, but mayonnaise and pickles. That's it,
and
nigga.
And some regular sauce, but that shit.
So it's just like the Chick-fil-A joint, just got a better bun.
But they got some, yeah, that too, and they got a better sauce on it at the top. I don't know, bro. That shit is good.
Yeah, yo, I don't know,
bro. That
like,
shit
is good. So, should you add anything to it? Like,
nah, look at Gunna, look at
Gunna. They was to add some cheese, though.
Yeah, you can add a cheese. If you add a cheese to it, but Popeyes don't have cheese.
All right, so now let's say I go to Chick-fil-A and get the what's the motherfucking sauce?
Filet sauce?
Huh?
The filet sauce?
No, not the Chick-fil-A sauce. Polynesian. You think that joint, the Polynesians take that motherfucker to a whole nother planet?
I don't know, cause I fuck with the Chick-fil-A sauce.
Oh, you fuck with Chick-fil-A sauce? Oh, nigga, you light. Nigga, yo, everybody know Polynesian, is it?
I don't really fuck with Chick-fil-A like
yo,
that.
Yo, Polynesian sound like a race. Like, yo, I only fuck nigga with Polynesian chicks.
I think it is a race. That's it. I think it is a race.
Yo, man.
If they taste like that, yo, only fuck with Polynesian.
Shout out to John 215. Global Tunes.
Yo, but listen. Go get a chicken sandwich, man. I promise you. It's that's where it's at. But don't please don't hurt anybody. It's not that deep. Please.
Yeah, that's crazy, yo. That stabbing probably happened in North Philly, didn't it?
I was going to stop and get one a day. Yeah, I called Popeyes and they ain't answering. I ain't feel like taking a chance.
You calling them niggas? Niggas ain't answering the phone. Popeyes didn't answer the phone.
Dog, yo, is that sandwich there before I get there? I don't want to come down that motherfucker.
It might nigga, if you call, man. If you call and ask for
this nigga calling to pre-order the sandwich
as an employee, I'm purposing. Yo, bro, we sold out of them bitches, bro.
This nigga calling.
That shit over.
This nigga calling.
I don't want nobody coming up this bitch. Fuck you talking about. That shit over.
Yo, we ain't got nothing.
I'm about to get fired. Like, nigga, you fuck that. I am bro, taking this shit the fuck home.
You ain't even peep this nigga calling, bro, to pre-order the chicken sandwich.
Hey, yo, what nobody pre?
Nigga, put that shit on pre-order like it's 2K.
Nigga, they gonna be like, yo,
that shit already pre-ordered. They got them motherfuckers, man. So they walk in the morning, yo, just start making them fucking sandwiches, dog. Just start making sandwiches, man. Because they about to fly you off the fucking meters. Nigga. Don't nobody want no two-piece. Don't nobody want shit today. But like, these sandwiches.
They gonna be like, Gunna, it's a lot of chicken, it's a lot of bread, and there's a lot of pickles missing. And there's a lot of bacon, and we don't even sell bacon. I don't even know where the fuck bacon came from. Like, yo, because I'm putting bacon on that bitch. Like, yo.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie. If I was an employee too, oh yeah, I'm definitely stashing sandwiches.
Yo,
I'm stashing sandwiches, and I'm definitely
like, nigga, how you get a double? How you get a double motherfucking Popeye chicken sandwich?
Yes, yo, I'm definitely walking out of that bitch with a book bag full of sandwiches.
I'm making a McChicken double.
Yeah, man, I'm making my paycheck in one swoop. Soon I leave out that bitch, I got them bitches for $20 a pop.
I'm about to put it in the motherfucking app just to work there for a day. Just so $7. I can get the sandwich for free.
They $7. I'm selling them for $20. And they gonna
the
be
sandwich sweet itself is $7?
Well, no.
It's not a meal?
I think it's a meal. I'm just talking shit, man.
Dude, so what it come with? Fries?
Nigga, that shit just come with the sandwich and the drink. You don't need fries, nigga. Just a sandwich and a drink.
Oh,
that's
fuck
it.
No. $7. Eat
nigga,
a dick.
Nigga, that's all you need.
Nah, I don't want that shit no more.
That's all you need.
White Castle or something.
Nah, I want that shit. I'm lying.
Yeah. I bet you do.
So go grab it, man. Only way to find out is if you will get this shit yourself.
And make sure you get them drunk cakes while you at it, man.
Oh my god.
Yeah,
watch when I pop out with my endorsement. Watch when I pop out my endorsement.
Oh shit, man.
I mean, we here. But anyway.
We here.
Anyway.
You gonna be sponsored by a motherfucking y'all want thong wear line.
That mean, hey, yo.
Yo, man, but I'm
pick
like,
up
yo.
Your new panties but, today but by like, Thomas.
But I'm like, yo, man, make sure you put them thongs on your ass or some shit. I'm going to have a nice little quote for that shit.
Why would I ever get a thong endorsement? The fuck am I going to endorse some thong, nigga? Like, the fuck?
Yo, y'all like, I swear I thought girls didn't wear thongs no more.
They don't.
That's what I said.
They
just go drawless. Like,
oh, all right, because I don't really like thongs.
Yo, if she got panties on, man, don't trust her. Yo.
We're not experts.
What?
We're not the experts to speak on this.
If she got panties on, don't trust her.
Don't trust her.
If she got panties on, don't trust her. If she got panties on, 9 times out of 10, she probably on her period.
Yo,
like,
if she got panties on, don't trust her because that means.
So that's the only reason why she got panties on?
Yo.
Hold up.
If she
got
them on,
hold up. What type of bitches y'all fucking with?
Hear me out. If she got them on, she's clearly hiding something.
What?
I'm just trying to spread.
We got a lady in the room right now, yo. I hope she got panties on. Oh, shit. Damn.
Woo! You mean?
I guess she don't. I don't know, man.
You judge it? Why you judging if she ain't got no panties on?
No, I'm not. But I'm just saying, man. Don't come in here. Don't nah.
She,
yo.
Like, she got jeans.
Like, they gotta have panties on.
She got jeans on.
But for what though?
Cause nah, man, yo. Don't be nah. Like you don't be walking around.
Why?
Just,
why cage the cat?
Just having a fucking your juices just dropping all in your jeans and shit like that. Like come
shit,
on,
it's gonna
man.
Be dropping in your panties. Haines. And that shit just keeping it there. Like, nah. Like,
nah, at least they got a line to ruin or something nah, like yeah, that.
Let them bitches roam free. Like, fuck that. Like, nah, man. I like leftovers.
Nah, yo. Oh,
this nigga clearly
don't that
sick.
Shit like gather something. Like, nah, yo.
Yo, this nigga. He said, don't that shit like gather
something. When it gather, what?
Like, nigga, that's why it's called soap and water, nigga.
Man. That's a great segue, actually.
That shit start gathering up the jeans and shit up. Yeah. Like maybe if you got like tights on and shit, yeah, man, I take that.
I don't know. You think? I don't know. I don't want to be rude, so I'm gonna let Tom control this because I was about to come off. Like,
I'm trying to figure out the video clip where T.I. was explaining why he go to the gynecologist with his daughter. And he caught a lot of heat for that, saying that he go with her. She's 23, and he still goes with her to make sure. How you say that word?
You took that very offensive.
The who? Oh, she's 18? Why she said she was 23? Must be the wrong daughter.
I was about to say, hold on, yo. Why is he still going to the doctor when she's 23? I was about to say, Tom, you sure, bro?
Even 18. Why are you going?
Yeah, even 18. Yeah.
But he said, but he's going to make sure she's still a virgin. Is that overprotective to a point where it's like, yo, you got to relax, bro?
Yeah, that's wrong.
I'm not a father. I'm not a father.
I got a son, so I can't really.
But I would think that is a little bit, you know, a little bit.
I mean, at the end of the day, I feel like this. She is 18. I don't feel as though that she's grown enough, even though that is a respectable age. That's considered to be a society respectable age to be a grown up. But as a person that had overprotective parents, even to be a man, like, you know what I'm saying, I feel as though, like, as a father, like, we don't, as parents, period. You don't get a manual. You don't get a, like, nobody can tell you, like, how to parent your child. Like,
that's
you know
true.
Saying? So if a motherfucker is under your roof until a motherfucker got a pot to piss in to throw it out and they can, like, handle shit on their own and I'm not paying for this as a father until you're able to do this on your own, then it's like, yeah, I think he has every right to do what he's doing.
You can parent. But, you can
but hold on. No, I feel where you coming from, though, Gunna, but at the same time.
No.
Until you assume.
You have to same time trust your child. You get what I'm saying? Like, that's just going. I don't know. Like,
I mean, I'm not.
Why are you trying to make sure she's a virgin at 18?
But at the end of the day, is he?
You ain't gonna be there every step of the way.
But is he trying to make sure she's a virgin to condemn her, or is he trying to make sure she's a virgin to also fair warn her? Like, you want to also know. Like, I feel like as if I was a parent. Like, you know what I mean, even when it comes down to the simple things like smoking weed and different things like that, I will want to roll up with my child. Like, I will want to smoke with my child. I will prefer my child to smoke with me because I want to know what my child is smoking. Like, at the end of the day, I want to know where you're getting your weed from. I want to know this shit because at the end of the day,
he checking to see if she fucking it, but like, all right,
but it's the same difference.
You like.
I'm not agreeing with that one.
That's cool.
That's you. Right. That's your parenting. You know what I'm saying?
That's me. Like, because even though
I'm big, high, boosy, nah, nigga. We not fucking rolling a blunt together, nigga. You got me fucking chopped, though. You think I'm about to sit here and roll a blunt with your young ass?
If you're going to do it anyway, I want to know what you're doing so I can teach you.
So at 12? At 12?
Warn you about the certain things, difference out here. Fuck no, not... At the end of the day, it will be a teaching moment and different things like that. But at the end of the day,
like, what age is you rolling up with your son? 16. Let's talk about it, sis.
Like, right. But no, like for instance, like if I know my child is starting to like experiment or do certain things, and I feel like they're sneaking around, and I start to like pick up on it and different things like that. All right, it's going to be a conversation. I'm gonna warn you, different things like that. Let you know what I do. Let you know what I did. How I lived as a parent. Like, you know what I mean?
It's not about you rolling up with your son.
What age? What I would like to like be permitted or
your daughter? How about that?
I'll say 16 would be a cool age. Like 16, because it's like you still about to like go out there and experience the world. You in high school. I mean, it's gonna be pressures and different things like that.
Fuck no.
I don't want you to feel like you have to hide
shit. I ain't gonna lie, I was smoking.
You see what I'm saying? I don't want you to feel like you're gonna hide shit because at the end of the day, then they'll go out with their friends. They'll go out with their friends and then they'll be like the hype bees and then they wanna try shit because they feel like it's cool. Like, no, nigga, I roll up with my pop. I'm cool. I'm good. I got my own weed. Like, you know what I'm saying? I want my child to be that child, so he don't feel like he gotta try shit. You get a lace blunt. Now my fucking child out here on some fucking wiggles and shit, and some dumb shit. Like I seen somebody walking down the street sucking on the fucking lollipop with their eyes. That shit is like I don't. I wouldn't want that experience for like my child. So I would want them to be either equipped and not be afraid to come to me with shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? And I mean, I'm not gonna say like I'm gonna make it okay and cool or whatever like that, but like, yo, if you want to experience it, I would want you to experience it with me, because I can at least control and see what the fuck you're doing and understand the substance, and you'll be okay with coming to me with these issues. Or okay, yo, pop, I want to drink, I want to do this, like, I mean, like, cool, all right, yo, son, like, I mean, I have DUIs and different things like that. You want to be careful. Like, yo, da da da. Like, yo, liquor wears off in an hour. Like, you know what I mean? Sit down, drink some water or whatever like that before you try to get back on the road or whatever like that. I'm not going to sit here and act like you're not going to drive drunk, because, nigga, my parents tell me all the time not to drive drunk. And, nigga, what the fuck we do? We drive drunk, nigga. You know we do.
I definitely be driving drunk out here, man.
Don't promote that, please.
We not promoting this shit, but nigga, we know this shit happens. Like,
hey, yo,
don't drive drunk.
Yo, I'm more of an experienced driver when I'm driving drunk.
All right, we not promoting this shit, nigga. We not promoting this shit.
Okay, I turned the fucking NASCAR.
And all in all, they said that T.I. heard how many syllables was in the word gynecologist, and he figured he had to be there.
Yo, man.
OBGYN or something like that. What the fuck they be calling that shit?
Shout out to Twitter. All in all, T.I. need to just fall back a little bit. What, me, I mean?
She 18, bro.
Give her some space, bro. God damn.
Just a little bit of space.
She 18. You know what I mean? And
it's probably got to, maybe he don't have trust in his daughter or something like that. Maybe got to build up a little bit more trust or some shit. I don't fucking know.
Like, I mean, and then it's like.
But shout out to T.I. and his new podcast.
I ain't even going to hold you. Even if I had a daughter, it wouldn't be. I wouldn't.
He probably talked. Did he talk about that on his podcast?
I think so. That's why we got.
That's how everybody know.
That means his podcast making rounds.
Yeah.
It wouldn't be a thing of rather if she's having sex. It's more so how often and how many partners like will be a concern for me. Like I wouldn't be. Like as a parent,
ain't gonna change what she's doing.
No, I ain't gonna lie, yo. What? My daughter being 18, that would be a concern for me.
I need to know if my daughter's a guy. That would be a concern.
I'm 18 and I've been with 5 different people. So
nigga, that shit would be a fucking concern for me, nigga. Yeah, we gotta have a fucking talk.
What you gonna do?
What you mean? What we gonna do?
What you gonna do?
We gonna have a fucking talk.
What is talk gonna fix?
All right. Yeah, all right.
You gonna talk, nigga. You gonna abandon your daughter?
No, we ain't gonna abandon
my daughter. Y'all niggas ain't fixing shit with no damn talk. She gonna do what she want.
Man, no, nah, my daughter ain't gonna be no Tatiana, man. My daughter ain't gonna be no thot. You heard?
Daughter ain't gonna be no motherfucking hoe.
Five bodies at 18 is too much?
5 bodies at 18?
Yeah.
Your body counts even still matter?
Starting at 16 to 18.
Nah.
No, they definitely start before 16. Yeah. No, 5 bodies by 18, it's cool. It's cool.
That's about normal.
That is about normal. Yeah, that's cool.
Depending on, and that's if she's not, that is like, when that's you start. If she's not super fast. That's like,
right. Niggas is out here for these little girls is fucking, man.
Do y'all still care about body count?
Fuck no. Like, who cares about a body
count? I don't give a
fuck
about a body count nowadays, man.
I think it's weird that motherfuckers even still ask that question.
Yeah, I feel like it was some young bullshit. I feel like
I'm not even asking you. Like, that shit.
Right, I care less.
I really don't even give a fuck
if you got a boyfriend. Yeah, like I'm not even asking you that shit. I don't even.
Because I don't want you asking me shit.
Like, don't ask. I don't even ask that shit.
Offer it and be like, yo.
Like, yeah, you offer information or whatever like that, or you ask.
I've been with 65 men.
All right, now, since I know, you see what I'm saying? Once you tell me, I'm gonna probably fall back. You know what I'm saying?
65 like, at 28 is too much?
Yes, it is.
Nigga, no.
That's way too much. What? Nigga, no. What? You tripping? This bitch a porn star or something? Who the fuck is this bitch? She Jada Fire?
She's a motherfucking
a sex bird.
Yeah, she's a free-spirited woman, probably.
Nah,
like, you know what I'm saying?
Guess what? Take your free-spirited ass to you. Because
on average, think about this.
I don't like fucking with free-spirited
because
bitches.
Listen. But real quick, on some real shit, think about this. Think about how often niggas fucking dick.
So I don't want to fuck with a bitch that's getting fucked.
And you hold on, and knowing that first of all, more often than not, more
you
often,
let all the other niggas fucking dip. Why you want me to wife you?
So more often than not,
I hate when I'm it get to
do that shit too.
I hate when it get to that. Why? Why do I got?
That's
be
only
the
because
guy?
You got a heart, nigga.
Why do I gotta be the guy? That gotta save you. Like, you gotta try and put me through all the loops and
like
shit.
Like, you had a text me.
But you just let my man
hit free of charge.
Free of fucking charge.
Let him now.
Your man
free.
Was different.
But, like, yo. But you wanna tell me you hungry and you got feelings for me.
Like, shit.
Like oh, now you no. Got
yo.
Me,
some,
right, you got
some shit you can get in 3 days. Some shit take a week.
The fuck am I
some
doing
shit take
right?
3 months. Some shit take a year. Like, the fuck?
You got feelings for me.
It's different strokes for different folks. Literally.
What the fuck did I do different than my man did? What the right. Fuck, yo?
Shit. Or, yo, your man had a vicious tongue game. That's probably what it was. Like,
pause. No, pause. Nigga. They be wanting me hate, to be the boyfriend, dog. I hate that shit, yo.
You got some wild ass niggas out here.
I don't
niggas
wanna
be
the boyfriend.
Ass, all types of shit.
That's where it's at.
And they be. Yo.
Whoa.
What?
Oh.
Someday I gotta grow up, man.
Yo, take this show to the next level. I forgot time. Dude,
take this show to the next
man.
Level.
Hey, yo, man, I be forgetting Tommy going to the market, yo. Like, yeah, yo, man.
He shop for groceries and can't cook for shit.
Right. Yo,
I can cook.
Yo.
If I
nigga see me shopping and can't cook for shit.
It depends on what you get. If I'm getting cereal and milk, that's an easy combination. In the bowl, we cooking, you know what I'm saying?
Real shit.
Yeah.
But I hate when motherfuckers try to say, well, you won't do shit that you not grown.
Take it to the next level.
Nigga, yo, hold on. Yo, first of all, that next level is going to take a lot of motherfucking tick before I get
yo,
there. Like, you know what I'm saying?
He's like 47, man. Come on,
nigga,
man.
I don't give a fuck. Like, I'm not saying that I'm like, I'm completely opposed. I'm just not.
Yo.
Yeah, I mean, that shit just don't happen for everybody.
I've never done it yet. Do y'all hate when girls be like, yo, I can't talk to you because I have to talk to your friend.
Yeah, it depends on the type of motherfucking friend. Because one, I wouldn't be trying to talk to you. If I really feel my nigga was a friend.
Come on, man. We've been in this situation.
I mean,
that's a different type of situation. Wait,
yeah,
that was a different type of situation.
Yo, man.
That was a. Yeah, me. That was a Blake Griffin CP3 situation.
Yeah, man. Right, definitely is Blake Griffin CP3.
Shit, nigga. Shit, I almost got 3-peated. Like, what the fuck you talking about? It called me later. I just flaked it. Like, you know what I mean? I'm like, what?
Damn. You
crazy.
Oh, you came through with the woo?
Yeah, try to hit me with some woo-wop. I'm
Griffin
like, get the fuck out of here.
Blake Griffin tried to throw up to DeAndre Jordan.
Right? Definitely DeAndre.
Nigga just couldn't mean she moved somewhere.
Hey, yo, man. But no, yo, I never really experienced that shit for real.
Nah.
I
mean, he get all. She don't ever get
I mean, the closest situation I could say is like having like a school friend. And it was like, I mean, not somebody I really necessarily hang with outside of the school walls, but inside the school walls, you know, like your friends was your friends inside of school. But like, I mean, you had like one situation where that kind of turned out where I kind of like swooped up, but it's only because I liked her first though. Like, you know what I'm saying? And the nigga already knew that before he bagged her. It's just because I used to be a nut ass nigga back in the day.
But nowadays, even if a girl did talk to your homie, if you, you know, if you.
They don't want you to care.
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
yo,
man.
I talk to you.
Yeah,
my number.
Chicks be want to keep shit more secret
he
than you do. Like, it be like, all right, cool.
Like they be trying to act
like yo,
you know,
just don't
yo,
be out here telling people. Like,
chicks,
like,
man,
it's
be really equality because they feel like they should be able to choose. Like, oh, I picked the wrong friend the first time, so I'm doubling back and I want you now. So, you mean?
But you can't do that to them though.
No, you did them. You a pussy good ass shit. Dickhead and yada yada yada.
You want some
let
nut
you,
shit?
Right, let you try and talk to one of their girlfriends. You get what I'm
you
saying?
You want some nut shit?
You want some nut shit? You a pussy? You like
you
said, you a pussy.
You all types
ass
of weirdos.
Nigga. You a weird. All this shit. Like, yo, man, it's all good though, love. I'm fucking with her now.
Mm-hmm. Cool. I'm with her, love.
And she fucking with me. How about that?
I mean, I'm kind of strategic. I might not go for
was
your,
she, was
your
she
inner
really,
circle, but I'll go
really,
for another friend.
Was she really your friend? How about that? Yeah, I'm saying.
I tried to tell you. All your friends ain't your friends. Yeah, man. I tried to tell you all them hoes ain't for you.
I tried to tell you that shit when I was with you.
Yeah, Chris Brown even tried to tell you these hoes ain't loyal.
Yeah, man.
Real rap. Yo, chicks' best friends be the worst. They be like your worst enemies. No bullshit. Let's see. What else we got on the docket, man? We skip past that.
That mean why we on like chicks and best friends and shit like that.
Chicks Tape 5? That'd have been a good segue.
Nah. I was thinking about the other. Chicks Tape 5?
What, chicks and best friends? About the, do you got a sample?
I mean, I could play something.
Yeah, man. Give us a sample, man, when we get to it. But Gunna, finish them.
I'm just going to keep talking about,
I was going to go into the sending KD. That was a little,
you know, when I woke up to that, I mean, and I heard Joe kind of alluding to something going on about that. You get what I'm saying? Like, I think that's an upgrade. But, I ain't gonna lie. Like, you don't think that's an upgrade? Come on,
man.
Tom.
Shout out to my man Joe.
Joe is my guy. No. We all fuck with the Joe.
She went from a bald headed nigga to a nigga with peasy head.
We fuck with the JPP up here. But come on, man. That's definitely an upgrade. From Joe Budden to Kevin Durant?
No.
No?
I'm loyal to the Soyuz. Shout out to my guy.
He said, I'm loyal to the Soyuz. Yo, what's up with you with the Soyuz, man? Yo, you now you loyal to the Soyuz with fucking Joe, and this nigga got fucking Safari, yo. Y'all niggas weird.
Hold, man. Hold on, dog. You know, yo, I ain't fuck with Safari, that nigga. Safari, bitch. I ain't fuck with Safari in a minute. You heard that shit was in like season one. We in like season three now. Yeah, man. I ain't fuck with that, man.
Listen, I don't know what really we can say on that, man.
I feel like
New York, my man in Brooklyn. Nah.
That's what's making it so crazy.
Even though, if I be honest, man, I think that this Joe and Sense is only for Love & Hip Hop storyline. If I'm being honest.
When does it come out?
I think this month.
Because I'm waiting for it.
I think this month.
I ain't going to lie. I'm waiting
or
for
next
that
month.
Shit patiently.
Either this month or next month. You would know better than I would.
But do you think it's any coming back
checking,
from that?
I've been checking my DVR every time I come home. Like, oh, that shit ain't on there yet? All right.
Do you think true love can overcome status?
I don't understand.
What you mean?
Because that's ultimately, like, because I feel like, all right.
You think
even
she messing with him because he's Kevin Durant?
Nah. I don't think that she's messing with him because
if he's messing with him because he's a legend?
I'm thinking more so future-wise, like, at the end of the day, like being with Kevin Durant and the type of success that his career already holds or whatever, like that, her status is going to become something different as, you know what I mean, as his career goes on, especially with him being in the Brooklyn market and all that good shit. And then with basketball players already making buku of fucking bread, that bread is different. That's what I'm saying. So at the end of the day, ultimately, future status versus like love, like, which I feel like she has with Joe.
Well, I think she do have love with Joe, but you know,
motherfuckers have to move on. And I'm not saying that she's like with him because of the status
for
Love
& Hip Hop storyline.
That's what I'm saying. Because if Joe was more so like, hey, I do love you, but we're doing it for TV, I feel like she's.
I don't think it's for TV no more, though.
That's it.
At first, I thought it was for TV, but then I started, you know, I'm seeing a lot of other shit. Joe fucking with his other little John now, you know what I mean? Like, so.
That's for the city.
I don't know, man. I don't think it's for the city. I mean, for Love & Hip Hop.
Yeah, man. Shout out to Monique, man. She just DM'd me the other day.
No, so you thinking like these them like dating these different people is like for a storyline?
Tom yes. think so.
Yes, oh, 100%.
At first I thought you meant
their relationship.
At first I thought it was, but not no more.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll have to wait and see what happens once the Love & Hip Hop shit come out. Or we'll wait and see when it comes out.
No, I can see that. I don't know. I don't. Well, Kevin Durant has been on a motherfucking promo tour like a motherfucker lately.
If Kevin Durant be on Love & Hip Hop, I'm going to be over it. It's definitely for a storyline if Kevin Durant is on Love & Hip Hop.
Like, I ain't even going to hold you.
If Kevin Durant be on Love & Hip Hop.
He's not going to be, but.
I was about to say, if he be on Love & Hip Hop, yeah, this shit is definitely for a storyline.
Yeah.
You mean?
He's been on a lot of, like, fucking from ESPN talk shows to, like, motherfucking podcasts. Like, Kevin Durant just been, like, spilling, like, the fucking beans, just being as real as motherfucking can be. That's why. And then a little bit about Kevin Durant, I really don't feel like he do fake shit too much for like media like exposure or whatever like that. So I don't really see like the relationship being fake with them. So I don't know. Like, you know what I mean? That's what I'm saying. So like if this shit actually takes off, like I could see her like status, like later on, like a la la and shit like that. Like, you know what I mean?
This nigga Gunna really had a deep dive.
Yeah, that's definitely deep.
Deep dive.
Nigga said she
man, listen, we're gonna get into new music, man, because it's a Philly podcast. We gotta mention that a Philly artist dropped a project. Quilly put out a project.
Definitely,
earlier this week. The name of the project was called, I also wanna talk about Chixtape 5 first. Haines and Money. I got a chance to listen to a little bit of it. 15 songs.
Give me something.
I can play something. I can play the intro. And we can see how it go.
Let me see how Quilly coming off.
Shout out to Quilly.
Shout out the title. Philly, you've been waiting for this shit.
Here's the money, I used to bag a lot. Now I got two ice phones, so I don't trap a lot. All these rappers pull OG to me, they just cap a lot. I want money like Jay and Prince, so I rap a lot. I'm a big score in my city, that's why I'm strapped a lot. Trapping all the nights with the metal on me like Camelot. I put in work with hard work and then overgrind. You ain't gonna score that easy, it's going overtime. Quilly Johnny going overboard. For all the bitches that jump ship, they sick, and I know for sure the streets back on who they voting for. I can never tell a hoe I'm yours, shit, I don't even open doors. Drag the bitches through the mud, cause they shitting on me. I'm laughing to the bank, you bitten on me. Just the kind of a law that was written for me. And with the fully switched, niggas switching on. Fuck with the devil on it like I'm playing for two. Sticks with the drums with me like I play for the roof. I'm just sitting smoke, say this, still playing the goof. Fly to LA, truck station, eating lobster.
I mean, one thing you can never take away from Quilly is his ability to rap. And I've been saying that, and I want to stand on that. Because he's one of the better artists from the city. Top three, I want to say. Oh, his Achilles heel is never being able to actually put a song, an actual song.
You saying Quilly is top three rapper. In what?
Rapper.
Rapping.
Bro. Rapping.
Respectably. Actually, I mean, tell you the truth.
We're not counting, like, motherfuckers that's patting already. Like.
Yeah. I know exactly what you mean. Like, you ain't even got to tell me that. I know exactly what you mean. tell you the truth.
Sean Smith is a...
We know, bro.
I was not...
No, but even with him, like, no. I can't put him in front of Quilly.
All right, relax.
Bro, I can't put him in
He's
front
a better
of Quilly,
rapper
bro.
Than Quilly, but...
He might be a better rapper than Quilly, but
that's what we're talking about.
No, like he's a lyricist though. You're talking about
that's clearly what you're talking about. We said rapper.
That's like comparing Nas and Jay-Z, bro. Who's
better, Jay-Z?
Exactly, but because that's what I'm saying. Quilly is Jay-Z. All
right,
this in this situation, in this scenario, in this scenario,
I get what you're saying.
This scenario,
I get what you're saying.
I don't mean like stature wise. Like we're talking about in this scenario, Quilly is the better rapper. But yes, I understand what you mean. Sean Smith is a better like lyrical rapper. He's not a better rapper than Quilly though.
Well, I didn't really listen to the tape yet. Yeah, I mean,
I listened to about the first three tracks because I got sidetracked. But it was sounding good. What I do want to say, like I said, it did sound good.
Any features on there?
He did have some features. He had Foreign Boy Osama, Mark Morrill, Foreign or Same Boy Trey Shells, and Rick Raw. So nobody really like that we know of, but shout out to them. Like I said, I gotta finish the whole project. I didn't really have prepared. Like,
I'm
gonna tune
it. Yeah,
but it did sound good. What I will say is that it did sound good. Quilly been chilling. So
no, people been waiting for this joint. He definitely been chilling, like trying to build up, build up for this project. Right. So hopefully it do good for him, you know what I mean? Cause he been out here. He kinda fell back for a while, but hopefully this joint move units, man.
Facts.
I'ma tune in.
More music, man. Chixtape 5 finally got a release date, man. November 15th. Check out Chixtape 5. Oh. I'm gonna say this now and proclaim this.
Oh, November 15th.
The best
December date this year?
The day before the guy's day.
The best R&B project to drop this year. My man hit me with the Yumi. Got the joint. Listen, man. November 15th, Chixtape 5, man. If y'all ain't heard, it's gonna be crazy, man. He going way overboard with the throwbacks. He got the the LimeWire stuff. He got the merch, like the. He just going back. Yo, man. AOL startup. You got Shanti on the cover.
I ain't gonna lie. This is how I came, you know, I wound up liking Tory Lanez because of this chick tape shit.
I tried to put him on.
Like, dog.
Plenty of times.
I tried to put him on too, man.
I know, but I fuck. But I'm here now.
After he played Proud Family and his nigga was staring about to cry in the wheel, like.
That's crazy.
Hey, yo. One day this nigga turned to me like, yo, this shit hit home, yo.
Yo. I am going to get a fucking light, man.
I just started fucking with that joint.
He need to put this. I'm gonna play something a little bit, cause you know we can play it. Cause it's about to come out.
Give it a preview.
Let it in.
Let's go.
Sweetness.
And I ain't got a goddamn snake.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, right. I was about to just say that too. I was like, Oh, okay. Time with the exclusive before this shit come out.
All right.
Hey, yo, Gunna, play that fucking Noriega shit you got too, man. Fuck, we dumping nothing but exclusives.
Yeah. My man Payne on.
Oh. That shit sound bad. That's a super exclusive. That shit too exclusive.
T-Pain tour is over.
Go into your shit.
Tape 5, man.
Chixtape 5, man.
Listen, man, I'm telling y'all know now, man.
I fuck with it.
I ain't gonna say that. R&B. Wise.
Nigga, you said that about us.
But then he released that. It was coming
but
out.
But now she about to, she talking about she retiring.
Yeah, but we don't believe him.
What's up with Summer, man?
J. Cole, too, man.
Come on, man.
He
ain't
say
don't,
he retiring.
On,
he just say he not doing no more features. He said, unless it's a Dreamville artist.
My man J. Cole about to drop that new tape soon too, man. Be ready for that. Be ready for that.
So
November 10th again, people. November 10th. November fucking 10th. We have Voltage Lounge, man. Come out, y'all. Come the fuck out.
Back for the first time concert. DJ Dior, Cartel. Y'all already know. Live performances by NABHE, Racks and others. You know what I'm saying? Pilot the Captain.
Yes.
It's happening.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? And we got some special guests that's going to be in the building.
Yes, Baltimore going to be in the fucking building as well. People is coming through. People is traveling for this show. So come the fuck out, people.
That's a fact.
So where would y'all rank T-Pain on y'all GOAT list, though?
GOAT. It's going to be $20 at the fucking door as well. $20 fucking dollars.
$15 for a t-shirt, though. Get into the concert free.
Hey, yo, we about to be the fuck out of here. All right. Shit.
Chixtape 5.
Gunna.
Artist.
Oh, wait, hold up. Wait, before you say that, T-Pain is in my top 5. Influential, definitely.
Well, I'm going out with the artist of the week.
Oh, if you got one, all right.
You know what I mean?
Since we hear me finish playing that Quilly shit, this is my artist of the week for the project. Since we ain't really, at least giving the rest.
You just played that shit.
About half of it, though. Oh, I'm sorry.
money, I used to bag a lot. Now I got two ice phones, so I don't trap a lot. All these rappers polo G to me, they just cap a lot. I want money like Jay and Prince, so I rap a lot. I'm a big score in my city, that's why I'm strapped a lot. Trapping all them nights with the metal on me like Camelot. I put in work with hard work and then overgrind. You ain't gonna score that easy, it's going overtime. Quilly Charney going overboard. For all the bitches that jump ship, they sick, and I know for sure the streets back, I'm who they voting for. I can never tell a hoe I'm yours, shit, I don't even open doors. Drag them bitches through the mud, cause they shitted on me. I'm laughing to the bank, you bitten on me. Just the cutter of a law, it was written for me. And with the fully switch, niggas switching on me. With the devil on it like I'm playing for Duke. Sticks with the drums with me like I play for the Roots. I'm the city's most hated, still playing the coup. Fly to LA, crushed Asia, eating lobster and soup, nigga. Sneakers with the bread ties, dinner with the snakes on them. Every gun I got, get a mop stick and a rake on them. Dick up to my frenemies, I still pray for them. A nigga try to stand on me, we gon' lay on them. No Instagram, nigga, I'm a nigga with a gram. I ain't no middleman, nigga, I'm a nigga with the gram. Don't call my phone and say you got it if that shit ain't in your head. Nah, nah. Look, they stay
here. Haines and Money intro, we'll get that, Quilly.
Man, turn the fucking volume up on that nigga, man. That nigga Quilly was just rocking.
Yo, November 10th, like I said, we gonna be at Voltage Lounge performing live.
In a BH.
She racked.
She fucking racked. Wild boy gang. Hey.
The She Racks count it.
Type of shit y'all gonna fucking hear.
Lock, she's sucking my dick, that's a lip. Lock, rolling recruits on the pit. Stop, that 40 be full to the tip. Top, trying to go flat out of rest. Watch, I'm rolling, I'm stepping, I've been high. Probably your 30, no end. Box, you know that I do what I've been. Drop, damn.
Yo.
Yeah.
Y'all heard him. November 10th, this Sunday, come out, please.
Yeah, she racks. Count it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And you already know this was another episode.
Before we get out here, let me ask you one question real quick before we leave. Yo.
Oh, the Twitter question. We ain't get the Twitter question. The Twitter question.
What's the craziest device you ever watched porn on?
The craziest device?
Like what's you watch something you watch porn on where you was like you shouldn't be watching it on that?
That I shouldn't be watching porn on? a laptop at school or something like a computer, like one of the computers at school.
A projector.
A projector.
Projector screen.
Yo, man.
Hey, yo, and no crazy part is I know where he was doing it. Yo, he a fucking nasty boy. Let's get out of here.
Yo, for me it was a PSP, man. Don't judge me.
PSP, yo.
That's some next level horny shit, man. Y'all niggas out of pocket, dog.
Yo, I just had to see what that shit looked like. It's the king's nigga.
Yeah.